Welcome to Microsoft Mechanics. Coming up on the show, if you struggle with identity management and the user sign-in experience for your consumer applications and websites, today we're going to take a closer look at Azure AD B2C, a new service to help you reliably and securely maintain your user accounts for your B2C applications. We'll show you the tech behind the scenes that makes it all possible and how you can quickly connect your existing web and mobile apps and allow your users to sign in with social network accounts and configure the service to scale your app to reach millions of consumers globally. I'm joined by Alex Simons, whose team has been working on this new service. Alex, what's the main premise of the new Azure AD B2C service?
Well, so Simon, what we're doing with the Azure AD B2C is we're letting you as an app developer use the underpinning infrastructure we've built up for our cloud scale services, right? The security, the worldwide availability, the high availability designs, and use those as the underpinnings for your own identity management system for your consumer applications.
So Alex, can you show us this in action?
Yeah, sure. Well, let's go ahead and take a look at a demo, okay? So this, as you can see here, is a Prosware app. Now, this is just fictional, but it's showing you what the service will look like when we use it, right?
Okay.
So here you go. I'm going to go ahead and sign up for the Prosware service. And I do that by just clicking. And you can see here I can log in with a Google account or my Facebook account. But I want to get a new Prosware account. So I'm going to click on that. And then the first thing you'll see is I can fill in my email address here to verify that I actually own this email address, right?
Yeah.
So I put in my account, I put in my information, I ask for a verification code, and then I'm just going to go over to my email here, get that verification code. And this is a nice way to prove that, yeah, I own the account. And all of this is done with no coding, right? If you're a developer, this whole flow, in fact, you can see here, I've got the email, it's been branded with my site, all that is taken care of for me. Now I just take this code, I put it back into the service, and now you as an app developer know, hey, that's been verified.
Cool.
Okay, so let's take a look here. I'm gonna put the verification code in. I'm gonna verify my code. And then I'm gonna do all the standard things you would expect. I'm gonna choose a password. I'm gonna make sure I have a display name. And then you can see here, I've got some custom fields, like my membership number is custom, and the offering type is custom as well. And then I'm gonna click the button, and that's gonna go ahead and create my account for me. And then this just hands back to my application. Now, what's cool about all this is all of that happened inside the Azure AD service. I didn't have to write any of that code as a developer. We took care of all of it for you. And you just get back a token and then use the token to do whatever you want.
So that's pretty cool. What's actually happening behind the scenes in order to make all of these things come together?
Yeah, well, it's a great question. So if I was building an app normally, what I'd do is I'd have my web app and I'd put a database on premise and I'd put usernames and passwords in the database. Mm-hmm. But the whole premise behind Azure AD B2C is that now I can take and I can move that data store up into the cloud in Azure Active Directory. So this has a bunch of benefits to it, right? So the first thing is that I can go ahead and I can easily connect it up to Facebook, Google, and Microsoft account. And the service does all that work for you, right? You don't have to know how to connect to those. And then if those services ever change in a way that might break your application, well, we'll take care of that and just keep it working for you.
Nice. Right?
Okay. So that's a pretty nice benefit. The second thing is that we take all of the data and we spread it around our data centers all around the world, right? So no matter where a customer is logging in from, they get a nice high-speed experience because it's local, right, and close. But in addition, it's distributed, right? So we've got copies of your data all around the world. So even if a data center burns down, we can just reroute traffic to another data center and make sure that your login service is always up and running. Right, so that's really very powerful as well and would be very expensive for you to do yourself.
Yeah, that's pretty cool. What are we doing from a security angle, though? People are going to want to have this information very secure.
Well, so that's a great question, too. Today, there's a lot of hacking going on. People are constantly trying to get in and get the usernames and passwords and things out of one of these services. So the first thing we do is we offer a multi-factor authentication service, right? So every time a user logs in, you can prove, well, it is the user who you originally thought it was. So that's a nice addition, right? But even more important than that, we're taking care of all of the patching of the service. We're taking care of making sure that the usernames and passwords are appropriately protected with encryption and hashes and things like that. Plus, we have a really amazing machine learning service that's watching all of the authentications across Azure Active Directory, across your application, across the Microsoft account system, taking all of that data, billions of authentications every day, and using machine learning to detect unusual behavior. So hackers coming in from weird places, unusual usage patterns, people logging into accounts at times of day they usually don't, things like that, we can all see in our machine learning system and then automatically block those anomalous behaviors so you don't have to worry about hackers getting into your application.
Wow, that's pretty amazing. What about if I didn't want to use all of the social services? Say I just wanted to use Google and Microsoft, but I didn't want to use Facebook. Do we have that flexibility?
Yeah, well, let me show you a demo of how you set this up. It's really easy.
Okay, cool.
Okay. So we're going to go into the Azure AD console, and you can see here I'm going to go into my tenant. So let me just go ahead and show you. I'm going to go into my tenant, and you can see here I've got this setup for a bunch of apps, but my first app here that we're talking about is Prosware. So I click on the Prosware. Now I can pick which identity providers I want. So you can see here I've got Facebook and Google selected, but I don't have to use those. I just have chosen to in this case. I can also set the attributes I want. So for instance, you can see here, these are all kind of standard attributes, but I've also added custom ones like membership number and offering type that we saw on the sign-in pages, right?
Okay, cool.
So that's pretty cool too. And then the magic though really of the service is what we call policies. All right, and so here I've got my standard sign-up policy. What a policy is it's a flow that dictates how my application is going to handle different identity tasks. So for instance, I use a policy to set up things like which set of attributes do I want to collect, which identity providers do I want to use, what do I want to get back in the token, and how do I want the whole flow to work, right? And all of that's done through metadata, so you don't have to write any code as a developer to do it.
Nice.
So here, let me show you how that works, okay? So I've got my standard policy here. The first thing I do is, you can see here, I've picked the identity providers I want to use, Google, Facebook, and email. Then I've gone ahead and I've set up which set of attributes I want to use to collect from the user. And then finally, I'm going to set which set of attributes are going to get passed to me as claims in my token. So this is nice too, because now when I get back a token, it's going to have all the things I need to really make a custom experience for the user.
That's very cool.
Yeah, it's very cool. Now the next thing I'm going to do here is I can go into the multi-factor authentication and decide if I want to use that or not. So that's pretty cool. In this case, I'm not going to use it. And then finally, I can specify how do I want the user experience to look like. And I want mine to be highly customized. So first, I'm going to specify what I want to call all the different fields. And then you can see here, I can even specify where the HTML and the CSS that we're going to use to render this page for you, right? So it's going to look just like your service. It's not going to look like a Microsoft service because you've provided us the whole layout and what everything looks like. We're just going to render it for you, put all the fields on, and make sure the flow you've called in a policy works.
That's pretty cool. So it's got all my corporate branding on there. All of my application is going to look exactly as I expect. What about if I'm building not maybe a web application, but I'm building something for, say, iOS or Android? Have we got folks covered on that one?
So we get a lot of asks for that, right? Because everybody wants to build a cool app for iOS or Android. The good news is that Azure Active Directory is all based on open protocols and open standards,
nice.
Right? So all of these different platforms you might want to write an app for can easily connect to Azure AD. But in addition to just having open protocols and standards, we also have open source libraries, right? So if you want to get in and make changes or fork or do things for your particular app, you can do that. So here, let me show you. On the Azure site, you can see here, here's the Getting Started page. This gives you links to all those things, but you can also see here on GitHub, here's my iOS libraries, here's my Node.js libraries, or if you're the kind of guy who just wants to write right to the protocols, we even give you the standards here for how to go and use these examples to write right to the protocol.
That's pretty incredible. I mean, the fact that it's all built on open standards must mean that there are some folks out there that have already implemented this inside of their application. Have we got any really good examples?
So one of the most exciting ones is Real Madrid. You know, they're one of the most popular football clubs in the whole world. And they're using Azure Active Directory B2C to power their iOS, Android, and Windows Phone apps. So here, let me show you. On this iPhone here, I've loaded the Real Madrid app,
yeah.
And I'm not registered as a fan yet. So what I do is I click on I'm not registered yet. This goes out, uses the Microsoft system, right? So Azure Active Directory B2C right here, and you can see I can sign up with Google, Facebook, or my email. And I just click through, and that's going to start using the service. But you can see this whole thing just looks like the Real Madrid application, right? But it's all powered with Azure Active Directory B2C.
That's pretty awesome that they've actually been able to build that in so quickly. Presumably very few lines of code that they actually needed there.
Yeah, super fast to integrate, right? Almost no code because all of it's done in the policies like we were talking about on the service. We take care of all the complexity for you.
That's nice. So what kind of things are you guys actually going to be adding in next into the service.
Yeah, well, so this is the first preview that's live right now. We've got a lot more work to do. So we're going to add in additional identity providers, more security capabilities, a lot more tools, and including tools that let you migrate from an existing store, like if you're using a database on-premise, up into Azure Active Directory so you can easily get it started.
So when is Azure AD B2C going to be available to folks?
Well, so Simon, it's available in preview right now. But we expect to turn it on into GA in Q1, but you can get started already. You don't have to wait. In fact, the first 50,000 users you want to store and the first 50,000 authentications that you use every month, those are free.
That's pretty cool. Okay, so we want you to keep giving us feedback on the product. That does make the service much, much better. That's all we have time for now on Microsoft Mechanics. Don't forget to follow us every Wednesday so that you can find out what's happening or as news breaks. Thank you very much for watching.